So here's a question. If you find yourself fascinated by nature, say the nesting habits of woodpeckers, should you worry that studying them will lead you away from your faith? Or if you're energized by your time staring into the fascinating world only seen through a microscope, will it lead you to believe that you have no soul? Or if you regularly ponder the wonders of the stars up above, will a career or hobby in astronomy make you question the existence of God? While these questions may seem absurd, the rocky relationship between science and some streams of Christianity has led some to conclude that believers should not be involved in the study of what they encounter in the outdoors, under a microscope, or twinkling in the galaxy. Is that the case? And if not, why do we believe that what we learn from doing science will conflict with the meaning we derive from our faith? It turns out the conflict is not so much between science and faith as it is between opposing worldviews. If you're not familiar, a worldview is a philosophical understanding of how you believe the world to be. Your worldview influences how you answer big questions like, who are we? Why are we here? Where are we going? And how did this world come to be? Your worldview defines how you see the world and your place in it. But what does this have to do with science? As you probably know, we use science to answer questions about the natural world through observation and experiment. You may not know that it's a verb, it's something you do, it's not a collection of facts. Science is a valuable process that can answer questions that theology does not fully address. Christians should not fear science. It produces a better understanding of God's creation, and thus, it should produce a better understanding of God. The tension comes from some underlying assumptions about how science should be performed. A widely held modern approach to science called methodological naturalism limits scientific explanations to only natural causes. According to this standard, any reference to God, miracles, or the supernatural should not be included in answers to any of our scientific questions. This guideline is mostly harmless and even wise when applied to most day-to-day scientific studies. However, it sometimes gets inappropriately applied to all questions, not just scientific ones. When this happens, methodological naturalism can morph into a naturalistic worldview, whose adherents conclude that there is nothing but what we can see, detect, and understand, and therefore there's no supernatural, no miracles, there's nothing after this life, there's no bigger meaning to life, and obviously, there's no God. So the practice of science can reveal fascinating insights about God's creation. But some mistakenly believe that science can answer every question, which puts them on a path to a naturalistic worldview. This is a concern, and that's part of the Christian apprehension with science and an aspect of the perceived conflict. Now, a conflict, even just a perceived one, requires two sides. So what do some scientists struggle with regarding Christian beliefs? That question has at least two answers, and similarly, it's tied to worldview. Christians typically respond to worldview questions with answers like, humans are bearers of the image of God. We're here to participate in God's kingdom and to glorify God. We're here to love each other and to steward God's creation, and we're headed into an afterlife determined by our faith in God. These conclusions and others like them are matters of faith. They're derived from the Bible, and they can't be tested with an empirical study of the natural world. Thus, we shouldn't be surprised that they frustrate those with a naturalistic worldview who often believe that science is capable of answering all questions. The relationship is further complicated by some Christians who reject scientific conclusions if they believe that the Bible provides clearer answers. This makes the blood of especially atheistic scientists boil. For example, Richard Dawkins, the Oxford evolutionary biologist, believes that Christianity stifles scientific inquiry. He wrote, "I am against religion because it teaches us to be satisfied with not understanding the world." Further, he argues that any belief in miracles is flat contradictory, not just to the facts of science, but to the spirit of science. While Dawkins does not represent all scientists, he's not alone in his concern that a willing rejection of scientific conclusions on select topics like the age of the Earth and evolution can yield a mentality where Christians are comfortable rejecting any scientific discovery that doesn't fit their notion of the world, leading to a naive understanding of science and how the world operates. As Christians, we have a responsibility to tend to this tension. Faith in scripture on one hand, and scientific discoveries about God's material creation on the other. We at Disciple Science believe there is a way to responsibly deal with these questions, and we'll discuss a path forward out of this conflict in a future video. Stay tuned.